أهلا بكم أعزائي الطلبة والطالبات طلاب الثانوية العامة في حلقة جديدة من برنامج مدرسة على الهواء. النهاردة بإذن الله هنكمل الموضوع اللي ابتديناه الحلقة اللي فاتت. احنا آخر مرة كنا اتكلمنا عن الديناميك الكتريستي وخدنا مين كونسبتس which are related to the dynamic electricity. المرة اللي فاتت اتكلمنا عن الكرنت انتنسيتي and the potential difference and the resistance. النهاردة هنتكلم عن الريزيستنس، وبعد ما نتكلم عن الريزيستنس هنبتدي نتكلم عن two other concepts which are the resistivity and conductivity، وهنقدر نعمل تفرقة بين ايه هي الريزيستنس وايه هي الريزيستيفيتي. طب احنا اخر حاجة وصلنا لها المرة اللي فاتت ان any current moved inside a conductor is phased by a resistance. Any current moved inside a conductor phased by a resistance. طب why it's phased by a resistance؟ We have said that it is due to the collision between the molecules of the conductor and the electric current or the negative electrons moved inside the conductor. طب وقلنا ان في scientist called Ohm he made an experiment to find the relation between the potential difference and the current intensity. طب تعال نشوف شكل الالكتريك سيركت اللي هو عملها وازاي ابتدى الاكسبيرمنت بتاعته. طيب first we have said that during his experiment he bring a resistance R. He connect this resistance to another resistance but it is a variable one called rheostat. Then he connect it to a source of voltage or a battery as you can see in this circuit. Then he connect a device called the ammeter to the conductor to measure the electric current intensity. Then he connect another device which is voltmeter to measure the potential difference across the terminal of the conductor. Then he start to find the reading of the ammeter and the reading of the voltmeter and the ammeter. Then he put them in a table. So here is V and here is I. As an example الارقام دي اللي هنقولها مثال مش حقيقي. He found that if the potential difference is 10 the current intensity is 5 ampere. Then he began to change the rheostat value. He began to increase the resistance of the rheostat. ابتدى يزود ال resistance بتاعت ال rheostat. He finds that the potential difference decreases to 8 and the current intensity decreases to 4. And he repeats this step many times, increasing the resistance of the rheostat and find the reading of the ammeter and voltmeter. So if it is become 6, this will be 3. طب what did Ohms conclude from this experiment? Ohms find that there is a direct relation between the current intensity and the potential difference. So this is the first conclusion which is concluded by Ohms or conclude from Ohm's experiment. He finds that the potential difference is direct proportional with the current intensity. And the second conclusion, as you can see from this point, if we divided V by I, it will give me a constant number or a constant value. He calls this constant value R, which is the ratio between the current intensity and the potential difference. So we conclude that the potential difference is direct proportional with the current intensity and the ratio between the potential difference and the current intensity is a constant value called the resistance of this conductor. So this is the conclusions of Ohm's law. So he concludes that there is a direct relation between the current intensity across a resistor and the potential difference across the two terminals of this resistor. Okay, so from this we can say that the potential difference is direct proportional with the current intensity. Okay, so if we want to draw a graph which represents the relation between the potential difference and the current intensity, this graph must be straight line from the origin. And the ratio between them or the slope of this graph is the resistance of the conductor. So This is the graph which represents Ohm's law. But this graph or this relation is only for the ohmic resistance material. There are other some materials which doesn't obey Ohm's law. يعني التجربة اللي عملناها دي مش بتنجح مع كل المواد، هي بتنجح مع أغلبية الكوندكتورز اللي هي الأسلاك العادية أو أغلبية الميتالز بوجه عام، لكن في ماتيريالز تانية زي السيمي كوندكتورز زي doesn't obey Ohm's law. في ماتيريالز تانية لا، ما بيبقوش ماشيين مع Ohm's law، لا ده الريليشن بتاعتهم تبقى inversely relation. These materials is like the semiconductor as we have said or the diodes. يبقى مش كل المواد اللي في الدنيا obey Ohm's law، مش كل المواد لو زودت الفولتج عند التيرمينالز بتاعها لازم الكرنت انتنسيتي which passes through it will be increased. لا، قلنا ده خاص بالاوميك ماتيريال بس، لكن في ماتيريالز ثانيه سميناهم نون اوميك ماتيريالز which are the semiconductors. As example for them is the diode. The relation is inversely relation. يبقى الجراف ده بيبقى صح او relation between the voltage and the current intensity is direct relation بالنسبة للأوميك ماتيريالز only not for all the materials. طب تعال نشوف هنا من السلايد دي. تمام، يبقى احنا لازم نعرف شكل الريزيستنس. We must know the face or the shape of the resistance inside any electric circuit او في اي بورد عندنا في البيت. ده شكل الالكتريك ايه ريزيستور، وفي كالرز بيبقى موجودة للالكتريك ريزيستورز دي. الكالرز دي فايدتها ايه؟ ان هي بتعرفني الفاليو بتاعت الريزيستور دي، وليه طريقة ان انا احسب الريزيستنس بتاع اي ريزيستور من الالوان دي، لكن مش علينا طبعا. وده طبعا بيوري شكل الموشن اوف ذا الكترون انسايد ذا كوندكتور ديو تو كوليجن وذ انذر الكترونز. وهنشوف في السلايد التانية دي هنشوف ذا واي اوف كونكشنز اوف اومز لو اكسبيرمنت. This is the battery. This is the battery. This is the ammeter which is connected in a direct relation, and this is the rheostat. And this is the ammeter. And this is the resistance. And this is the voltmeter which is connected parallel to the resistance. And from here we can find the value of V and I. وكده قدرنا نجيب relation which make a relation between the potential difference and the current intensity. طب let's see. This is the relation. The resistance equal V over I. It's measured by a unit called ohm relative to the or related to the scientist ohm. بالنسبة للعلم ohm. And its measuring device is ohmmeter. Okay, which is connected in series to any electric circuit. طب as we have said ohm the measuring unit ohm has a certain symbol which is this. This symbol represents the ohm. So this is measured by ohm, this is measured by volt, this is measured by ampere. طب if I asked you define the ohm, we first must say that ohm is the measuring unit of the resistor. So ohm is the resistance of a conductor when a potential difference of 1 volt is connected to its terminals, a current intensity of 1 ampere passes through it. So we can say ohm is the resistance of a conductor when the potential difference between its terminal is 1 volt, a current intensity of 1 ampere is generated inside this resistor. So this is the simplest way for explaining of the resistance. And you can see that ohm is equivalent to volt over ampere. So volt over ampere is the equivalent unit for ohm. So ohm has another equivalent unit which is volt over ampere. طب this is called the resistance. And this is a graph which represents the relation between the voltage and the current intensity for the ohmic materials and for the non-ohmic material. So the relation between the voltage and the current intensity differ from one material to another. And we must know from Ohm's experiment that there are two kinds of resistors. The first one is called a constant resistor, and the second one is called the variable resistor or the rheostat. طب what is the function of this rheostat adjust the potential difference and the current intensity in any circuit. ودي اللي على اساسها نقدر نقول قامت فكرة الزرار اللي بيقدر يعلي ويوطي الصوت في اي سماعة عندنا في البيت، حاجة اسمها البوليميتر. تمام. طيب let's study the factors which affect the resistance of any conductor. First, when they want to study the factors which affect the resistance of any conductor, they found that the resistance is affected by four factors. The first factor is the length of this conductor. So the first factor is the length of this conductor. The second one, as we have said, is the surface area, and it is inversely proportional with the surface area. The third one is called the type of material, the type of this conductor, the type of the material of the conductor. نوع الواير اللي انا بستخدمه، هل كوبر هل اي نوع تاني، ودي سميناه resistivity. The type of the material is represented by a physical quantity called the resistivity. And the last one, as we have said, will be the temperature. It will be the temperature. And we know that R is directly proportional with the temperature. And we have said that due to the increasing the vibration of the molecules of the conductor by increasing the temperature. And this will cause the molecules to make more collision with the moving electrons of the electric current. And this will increase the resistance of the conductor. So we have four factors affect the resistance of any conductor: length, area, and the type of the material, and the temperature. So from this we can say that the resistance is direct proportional with the length of the conductor and inversely proportional with the surface area in case of we're speaking about constant temperature. If you consider that the temperature which affects this conductor is constant. لو اعتبرنا ان temperature constant. So we can remove the relationship or this relation symbol and put the resistivity. The resistivity of any conductor. So we can say that the resistance equal resistivity L over the surface area. Okay. So from this we conclude that there is another concept which is called the resistivity. And the resistivity is related to the type of each conductor. طب what will be the resistivity? Okay, let's study the resistivity. طب before we study the resistivity, let's remember an old question. We have said that the resistance is directly proportional with the temperature. And we have said that the answer of this question will be because by increasing the temperature, this will increase the vibration of the molecules of the conductor, and increasing the collision between the molecules of the conductor and the electrons move inside these conductors. بس هل الريزيستنس دايما بتبقى دايركت ريليشن مع التمبريتشر في اي ماتيريال؟ قلنا لا، احنا في الشابتر ده بنتكلم عن الاوميك ماتيريالز. اما بالنسبه للسيمي كوندكتورز لا، او اللي هي قلنا مثال الدايودز والكلام ده، لا السيمي كوندكتورز ما بيبقاش في دايركت ريليشن، لا ده احنا هنفاجئ ان هي بتبقى inversely relation. يبقى احنا واحنا النهارده بنتكلم لازم نبقى نعرف ان احنا بنتكلم على ايه، على الاوميك ماتيريالز بس، اللي هي الماتيريالز اللي هي اوبيز اومز لو. طب اوكي، this is the first part. طب let's speak about the resistivity. What is the resistivity? Let's find a definition for the resistivity of any material. Let's see. As the last part we have said that the resistance equal the resistivity length of the conductor divided by the cross section area. Okay, from this law we can conclude that it is also equal potential difference over current intensity from Ohm's law. So these are two laws which represent the resistance of any conductor. From this law we can conclude the value of the resistivity. We can find that the resistivity equal R times A divided by L, resistance times the cross section area of the conductor divided by the length of this conductor. Okay, so how can we define it? We can say that the resistivity is the resistance of a conductor which has a length of 1 meter and the cross section area of this conductor is 1 meter square. So the resistivity again is the resistance of a conductor has cross section area 1 meter square and its length is 1 meter. This is the definition of the resistivity. So the resistivity is the resistance of a conductor has a length 1 meter and the cross section area of this wire or of this conductor is 1 meter square. And from this law we want to conclude the or find the measuring unit of the resistivity. The measuring unit of the resistivity, we have said it is resistance area divided by the length, so it will be resistance is measured by ohm, surface area is measured by meter square, the length is measured by meter. So meter cancelled with meter, the unit will be ohm meter. So the unit, the measuring unit of the resistivity is ohm meter, while the measuring unit of the resistance is ohm. And we have said that the resistivity represent the type of the material of the conductor. الريزستيفيتي دي بتمثل لي نوع الكوندكتور او الواير اللي انا بستخدمه. طب ايه هي الفاكتورز اللي بتعتمد عليها الريزستيفيتي؟ الريزستيفيتي ما بتعتمدش غير على حاجتين، التايب اوف ذا كوندكتور ماتيريال والتمبريتشر، لان احنا في التجربه دي او في القانون ده افترضنا ان التمبريتشر كونستنت، لكن لو اتغيرت التمبريتشر الريزستيفيتي بتاعت الماتيريالز هتبتدي ايه؟ تتغير. يبقى الريزستيفيتي نوت لايك ذا ريزيستنس، ذا ريزيستنس ديبند اون ذا لينث كروس سيكشن اريا تايب اوف ذا ماتيريال اند تمبريتشر، وايل ذا ريزستيفيتي از ا فيكسد نمبر فور ايتش ماتيريال اور ا فيزيكال بروبرتي فور ايتش ماتيريال ويتش ديبند اون ذا تايب اوف ذيس ماتيريال اند ذا تمبريتشر. يبقى اجين ليتس سي ذا ديفينيشن اوف ذا ليتس سي ذا ديفينيشن اوف ذا ريزستيفيتي. وي ويل فايند ذات ذا ريزستيفيتي از ذا ريزيستنس اوف ا كوندكتور هاز length 1 meter and the cross section area of it is 1 meter square and the measuring unit is ohm meter and it depends on what type of the material and the temperature of the material. So it isn't affected by the length or the cross section area. If I increase the length, the resistivity will be constant because it doesn't depend on the length of the conductor. If I increase the area, the resistivity will be also constant. So the resistivity is a physical property which show me the value of the resistance of each certain material. And this table show me the different resistivity of different material. Let's look at this table and it's very important one. جدول ده بيوريني resistivity بتاع مواد مختلفة. بنبتدي من silver, copper, gold, aluminum, tungsten, iron, platinum, lead and many conductors. From this we will find that which one of the conductors has the less resistivity. من الجدول ده مين الماتيريال اللي عندها lowest resistivity؟ silver and copper. So there is an important question in the, as a given reason he said that the copper is preferred to be used in the manufacture of the electric cables. ليه الكوبر is preferred to use in making of the electric wires and the electric cables؟ ليه بنستخدم الكوبر في صناعة الالكتريك كابلز؟ because it has a small value of resistivity. يبقى الريزيستنس بتاعته قليلة جدا، فبالتالي he will transfer the electric energy without any losing of them or a small loss of them in form of thermal energy. يبقى انا بصنع الالكتريك كابلز from copper because it has a material which has less resistivity. طب ليه مش السيلفر؟ ما عنده resistivity قال، بس ده طبعا رجع لسعر السيلفر العالي اللي مش هينفع اقدر اصنع بيه اسلاك طبعا، وان الكوبر سهل برضو في البولينج بتاعه على شكل كابلز. يبقى عشان الريزستيفيتي بتاعته قليله عاليه قليله والكوندكتيفيتي بتاعته ايه؟ عاليه، فهيعمل ديكريز للوزنج انرجي انسايد ذا الكتريك كابلز. This is called the resistivity. وده اللي احنا قلنا عليها الريزستيفيتي، which we as we have said it depend just only on the resist is the type and the temperature. Okay, this is the second concept in our lesson today. But there is another concept also. This one is called the conductivity. What is the conductivity? Its symbol is sigma E. Conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. Resistivity represents the resistance of fire has length 1 meter and the cross-section area 1 meter square. Conductivity represents the conduction of the wire or of the conductor, and it is the reciprocal of the resistivity, the opposite value of the resistivity. As we have said that the resistivity means R A over L, so we can conclude that the conductivity is the opposite of this law, so it will be R L R over A. So this is the resistivity, and the reciprocal of it is called the conductivity. From this we can conclude that the resistivity is also the opposite of conductivity. Now from here we find that the measuring unit is ohm meter, while here it will be ohm negative 1 meter negative 1, which is Siemon meter minus 1. So the scientist name is Siemon Ohm. So this symbol is called ohm to the name of his father, and the ohm negative 1 he called it Siemon relative to his name. So the measuring unit of the resistivity is ohm meter, while the measuring unit of the conductivity is ohm negative 1 meter negative 1, or it will be Siemon meter negative 1. Both of them are right. So we find that the conductivity. So again, if you ask me why copper is used in making of the manufacture of the electric cables, because it has less resistivity and more conductivity, so it transfers the electric energy with not much loss in the electric energy while transferring them from the distribution zones or from the electric power station to our distribution zones. And the conductivity is like the resistivity. Both of them depend on the type of the material and temperature. Okay, so we know that the conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. So if I multiply the conductivity of a material by its resistivity, the value will be 1. لو انا جبت الكوندكتيفيتي وضربتها في الريزستيفيتي بتاع نفس الماتيريال لازم هيديني 1، لان كل واحده منهم عكس الثانيه. The resistivity is the reciprocal of the conductivity and the conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. طب another important questions. If you asked me what's mean by the resistivity of copper equal 1.7 times 10 power negative 8. If you asked me what is meant by resistivity of copper is 1.7 times 10 power negative 8 ohm meter, and he want me to find a definition for this sentence. What's mean by the resistivity of copper is 1.7 times 10 power negative 8 ohm meter. From this I can conclude that, or I say that it means that the resistance of copper conductor has length 1 meter and cross section area is 1 meter square is 1.7 times 10 power negative 8 ohm. So the answer will be, again, it means that the resistance of a copper wire or a copper conductor that has length 1 meter and the cross section area of this wire is 1 meter square equals this number ohm. So this is one of the important questions, is how to define or find what's meant by the resistivity of any material equals this value. I will make the length 1 meter and the area 1 meter square, then the number is written downward واليونت اوم. ليه؟ لان احنا استخدمنا اللينس والاريا فوق، فما فضلش عندي غير ايه الريزيستنس تحت، فمش هحط اوم ميتر خلاص. يبقى again it means that the resistance of copper conductor which has length 1 meter and the cross section area is 1 meter square is 1.7 times 10 power negative 8. Okay. So we have studied 5 concepts related with the dynamic electricity topic. Let's move to how to solve problems in this part. Let's write all the laws which are found in this part. Let's see. Okay, the first one, we have said that the current intensity is the quantity of the charge passing through a conductor in 1 second. Second one, potential difference is the work done to transfer a quantity of a charge between 2 points. And Ohm's law said that R is the ratio between the potential difference and the current intensity. And we know that the quantity of a charge equals the charge of 1 electron times the number of electrons. And we have said that the resistance from Ohm's law is V over I, or it is equal to the resistivity times the length divided by the cross section area. And from it we have said that the resistivity equal R A over L, or the reciprocal of the conductivity. And the conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. As we have seen, there are about 6 laws related with this part. But there are other questions. But let's read this problem and try to solve it. Okay, let's read this problem and try to solve this problem. As you can see, this problem said that when a current of 2 ampere. So we have a current of 2 ampere passes through a non-resistor. The potential difference is 10 volts. So he gave me the current intensity of 2 ampere. And he gave me that the potential difference is 10 volts. Calculate the resistivity. So he wants me to find what? The resistivity. So again he said that when a current of 2 ampere flows through a non-resistor, the potential difference across it will be 10 volts. Calculate the resistivity of this resistor. Not only the resistivity, but the conductivity. Okay. If you know that the length of this resistor is 2 meters and the cross-section area is 0.1 centimeter square. Okay, it's easy one. Let's try to solve this. Okay, to solve a problem, we must first write the givens in the right side. Let's see. Givens. As you can see, let's see the givens. The first one, he tell me what? Current intensity equal 2 amperes. So I equal 2 ampere. I don't have to make any change on the units. Potential difference equal 10 volt. Okay, what else? He said that the length equal 2 meter and the cross section area 0.1 centimeter square. Oh, this must be changed because they give me the cross section area with centimeter square. To change centimeter to meter, I should multiply to the 10 to the power negative 2, while this is centimeter square. So it will be 0.1 times 10 to the power negative 2 power 2, which means 0.1 times 10 to the power negative 4, which is 1 to the 10 power negative 5 meter square. This will be the cross section area. Okay. But you want what? You want to find the resistivity. So we have known how to write the givens in the right side and change the units to the standard units. Let's see our problem. He wants the resistivity. The resistivity equal R A over L. The resistance of the wire times the cross section area of the wire divided by the length of this wire. Now let's see. The resistance I don't know the value of this resistance. The current intensity, I have the current, the cross section area, I have the cross section area, the length, I have the cross section area. So if I can find the resistance, I can find the resistivity. Okay. The resistance equal R, but this law will be not suitable one because I don't know the resistivity. There is another law, Ohm's law, V over I. This will be a one which is good for me. So R equal 10 over 2, which is 5 ohms. Then substitute it in the resistivity law. So this is 1. Substitute 1 in the upper law in 2. By substituting 1 in 2, we can find that 5 times 10 to the power negative 5 divided by what? 2. Then we will get the value of the resistivity, which is 2.5 times 10 to the power negative 5 ohm meter. This is the value of the resistivity. Okay, this is number one. We have found the first thing he wants. He wants the resistivity. We have found the resistivity. Then he wants me to find the conductivity. Conductivity, we know that it is the reciprocal of the resistivity. So it will be 1 over this value. And the answer will be ohms negative 1 meter negative 1. So this is the first problem. How can I use the previous laws in solving this problem? Let's move to another kind of problems. So what will happen if I compare between the resistance of two wires? But what will happen if I change the length of the wire? Would the resistance will be changed? It must be changed. Would the resistivity will be changed? Would the cross section area will be changed? Let's use or study how to solve by these laws. Let's see. These are comparing. If I compare the resistance of two wires together. If I am speaking about, this is one, if I compare between the resistance of two wires. We know that the resistance is the resistivity L over A. And A, if the wire is a cylinder, will be pi R square. The cross-section area of a wire is pi R square. Okay. If I want to compare between the resistance of the two wires R1 over R2, it must be resistivity 1 over resistivity 2, direct relation L1 over L2, while here will be A2 over A1. Why A2 over A1? Because the resistance is inversely proportional with the area. If he doesn't give me the cross section area and he give me the radius of the conductor. So it will be R1 over R2, resistivity 1, resistivity 2, L1, L2, R2 square over R1 square. Because the area equal pi R square. So there is a direction between the area and the radius square. And pi will be cancelled from the both sides. If he tell me that the two wires are made of the same material, I can cancel the conductivity because they must have the same conductivity. This is used only if I'm comparing between two wires. If he said two the same materials, I can cancel the resistivity if they are made of the same wire. There is another way of comparing of two wires. Let's complete the comparing between two wires problems. We're still in the two wires. If he give me the mass, not the cross-section area, we know that the resistivity is the mass over volume, and the volume is area times length of the wire. So we can find that the area equal mass over density over length. Okay, so if we speak about the area of the first wire, it will be mass of the first wire, density of the first wire, length of the first wire. So we can see that R1 over R2 equal, as we have said, yes, resistivity 1, resistivity 2, L1, L2, A2, A1. We can remove the area and put mass over length. And we can cancel the density and the resistivity if the two wires have the same material. If you said that from the same material, we can cancel the density and the resistivity. So it will be R1 over R2 equal L1 over L2 A2 over A1. We can replace the area with mass over length. Okay, so A1 will be cancelled by M1 L1. Okay, this is A1. And A2 will be cancelled by, okay, A2 will be M2 L2, and there is another L2. So M1 L1 represent A1, and M2 L2 represent A2. So R1 over R2 equal M2 L1 square M1 L2 square. This law is used if he doesn't give me the cross-section area and he give me the mass of the wire. القانون ده انا ممكن استخدمه في حالة ان هو ما ادانيش الاريا واداني الماس اوف ذا واير، ساعتها لازم استخدم القانون ده لان معيش الاريا. مش مهم عليا الاستنتاج جات ازاي اللي انا لسه قايله، المهم عليا اعرف القانون الاخير. طبعا انا هنا اهملت الكوندكت الريزستيفيتي واهملت الدنستي، شلت الدنستي من فوق وتحت والريزستيفيتي من فوق وتحت، باعتبار انه تو وايرز ميد اوف ذا سيم ماتيريالز. لو مش ميد اوف ذا سيم ماتيريالز لا مضطر ارجعهم تاني. بس هو دايما الجزء الاخير ده ما بيجيش فيه مسائل. بنرجع للجزء الاولاني اللي هي الصفحة الاولانية دي اللي بيجي فيها مسائل كتير. طب تعالوا نتعرض لمسألة منهم. Let's see. Okay. Let's read this question. He said that two wires made of different material. The length of the first wire is half the length of the second. Okay. The length of the first equal half the length of the second. So the first given, length of the first equal half length of the second. This is the first given. Then, the radius of the first equals the diameter of the second. The radius of the first equal diameter of the second. And the diameter is double the radius. So R1 equal 2R2 because the diameter is double the radius. So this is the first given. And they have the same resistance. So R1 equal R2. Find the ratio between their resistivity and their conductivity. طب let's try to solve this. طب let's write the givens again. Let's write the givens on the right side of the paper. He said that length 1 equal half L2. Let's write it in a simple way. So we can say L2 is double L1, and he said that radius 1 is diameter 2, so you can say R1 is double radius 2, and R1 equal R2. These are the three givens, 1, 2, and 3. And he said that find the ratio between their resistivity. Resistivity is RA over L. How can I find the ratio between the resistivity of the two wires? Let's see. We will write that resistivity 1 over resistivity 2 will be equal. R is directly proportional with the resistivity, so it will be the same. R1 over R2. A is directly proportional. A1 over A2. L is inversely proportional, so L2 over L1. He said that the resistance is the same, so we can cancel both of the resistors up and down together. So resistivity 1 over resistivity 2 will be equal, but he doesn't give me the ratio between the area but the radius. We know that area 1 equal R1 square and area 2 equal R2 square L2 L1. Let's substitute by the givens in this equation. So this will be equal R1 means 2 R2 square. L2 is 2 L1. And this will be R2 square and this will be L1. Let's see. L1 will be cancelled with L1. So there is only 2. 2R2 square will come from inside the root by 4R2 square divided by R2 square. Cancel R2 with R2 square. This will give me 4 times 2 over 1, which is 8 over 1. So the answer will be the ratio between resistivity 1 to resistivity 2 will be 8 to 1. This I comparing between the resistivity of the first wire to the resistivity of the second wire. So the radius will be doubled. So R1 equal to R2 square. If I make square here, this will be 4 R2 square. Cancel R square with R square. There is only 4. He want also, this is the first answer. He want also to find the ratio between the conductivity. Ratio between conductivity 1 to conductivity 2 will be 1 to 8. Why? Because there is the conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. هي مقلوب الريزستيفتي. فلو الريزستيفتي 1 على الريزستيفتي 2 بتساوي 8 to 1 يبقى conductivity 1 على conductivity 2 بتساوي اوكي 1 to 8. Let's move to another problem. Let's see this problem and this an important one. In the previous problem we have spoken about two wires. Let's see this. Let's read this one. He said that a wire was reshaped where its length becomes 3 times the old length. عندي واير خليت اللينس بتاعه جديد زاد 3 مرات. انا عملت له بولينج فروم ذا تيرمينال، سحبته من الطرفين. فاللينس بتاعه بقى 3 مرات اللينس الايه؟ قديم. عايز الريزيستنس بتاعته في الحاله الجديده دي. لو الريزيستنس القديمه كام؟ 5. يبقى احنا هنعتبر الحاله القديمه هنسميها 1 والحاله الجديده هنسميها 2. The length becomes 3 times its old length. يعني L1 equal L2 which is the new one equal 3L1 because 2 is the new. The new length is 3 times the old length and the old resistance is 5 ohm. He want to find the new resistance. Okay. طب let's write the givens again. We have know that the new length is 3 times L1 and R1 equal 5. Find R2. This 5 ohms. Okay. So we can say R1 over R2. It is the same wire, so I can cancel the resistivity. So L1, L2, A2 over A1. I have the relation between the length 1 to length 2, but I don't have the relation between A2 to A1. تمام. أنا لا يمكن أغير طول سلك من غير ما الكروس سكشن اريا بتاعته ما تتغير هي كمان. لو أنا عندي سلك وطولته من الطبيعي إن الاريا بتاعته هتزيد ولا هتقل؟ أكيد هتقل. لو أنا معايا سلك وابتديت أسحبه عمال أزود اللينس أبص ألاقي الاريا عمال يرفع. ما هو نفس الواير، إزاي هطول سلكه؟ مش أكيد طالما هطول سلكه هاجي على الاريا واقللها. فبالتالي اللينس والاريا عكس ايه؟ بعض. طب هنعمل ايه بقى لو نفس السلك ده القانون اللي احنا هنستنتجه؟ احنا طبعا الفوليوم بتاع السلك في الفيرست كيس هو هو الفوليوم بتاع السلك في السكند ايه؟ كيس. يبقى اقول اريا 1 لينس 1 must be equal اريا 2 لينس 2. So L1 over L2 will be equal L1 over L2 equal A2 over A1. يبقى أنا ممكن أشيل A2 على A1 وأحط إيه؟ L1 على L2. والقانون بقى الجديد هيبقى عامل إزاي؟ R1 على R2 بيساوي L1 times L1 L2 times L2. يبقى انا طالما بتكلم على نفس السلك مش سلكين مختلفين، طالما the same conductor مش two different wires، يبقى A2 على A1 must be equal L1 على L2، لان كل ما هزود اللينس اقل الاريا، عشان في inversely relation بين اللينس والاريا لو انا هعمل pooling للواير. يبقى R1 over R2 بيساوي 3L1 times 3L1 L1 times L1 اللي هو هيديني كام في الاخر؟ 1 على 9، يعني R2 9 R1 and R1 is 5، يبقى 9 times 5 which is 50 which is 45 ohm. Okay, this is the answer. It will be 45 ohm. يبقى أنا عرفت إزاي أحل مسائل الريزستيفتي in the same wire أو different wires. يبقى لو أنا عندي بتكلم على the same at two different wires هتبقى resistivity L1 A2 resistivity 2 L2 A1 عشان قلنا الأريا inversely relation with the resistance. طب لو قال لي نفس الريزستيفتي made of the same material بكنسل، يبقى L1 over L2 A2 over A1. لكن لو انا بتكلم على same wire، لو هنا بتكلم على one wire وهنا two wires، لو ال one wire ده عملت له pulling سحبته زودت اللينس بتاعه اكيد الاريا ايه؟ هتقل. فقلنا من الطبيعي ان هو يبقى L1 over L2 A2 over A1، لكن احنا قلنا هنشيل A2 على A1 لو ما عرفهاش وحط مكانها ايه؟ L1 over L2 ده لو انا ما اعرفش الاريا. وقلنا بتيجي ازاي؟ وقلنا ان انا لو اداني الماس هتبقى L1 سكوير M1 L2 سكوير M2، ده في حالة ان هما the same resistivity and the same density. لو مش the same resistivity هزود الريزستيفتي هنا. طب the same density هزود الدينستي برضو ايه هنا. لكن لو ما جابليش سيرتهم وقال لي the same material اكنسلهم. تمام جدا. طب في مثال برضو سهل جدا للحكاية دي، تعالوا نتعرف عليه. بيقول لي two copper wires the length of the first one is 10 meter and its mass is 0.1 kilogram and the length of the second wire is 40 meter and its mass is 0.2 kilograms. تعالوا نبص على المسألة كده، هنلاحظ ان هو هنا بيتعامل بالماسز، ما ادانيش اي معلومة عن الايه area. بيقول لي two copper wires the length of the first one is 10 ohm and its mass is 0.1 kilogram and the length of the second is 40 meter and its mass is 0.2 kilogram. قلت طالما اداني الماس ما ادانيش الاريا يبقى القانون هعمل ايه؟ R1 over R2 هتساوي L1 سكوير M2 L2 سكوير M1 وابتدي اشتغل عادي واشوف هيديني تمام. كلام جميل جدا. طب تعالوا نشوف مسألة تانية نتعرض وتبقى دي اخر مسألة عندنا. تعالوا نشوف كده. تمام، هنا بيقول لي two wires have the same length. اوكي، two wires x and y have the same length and the ratio between their diameters is 1:2. الريشو من الديامترز بتاعتهم 1 to 2، يبقى اكيد الريشو من الريديوس برضو 1 to 2، ما هو الديامتر دبل الريديوس، 2 هتروح مع 2. The ratio between their resistance is 2 to 1. Find the ratio between their conductivity 1 to conductivity 2. تمام جدا، مسألة سهلة. تعالوا نكتب الجيفنز. يبقى انت بتقول لي ان الريشو من radius 1 لريديوس 2 is 1 to 2 while R1 ريشو من الريزيستنس بتاعتهم is 2 to A 1، وعارفين ان الكوندكتيفتي عكس الريزيستيفتي، يعني RA L بالمقلوب كده، يبقى ريزيستيفتي 1 over ريزيستيفتي 2، وقلنا اللينس واحد فمش هحطه في القانون، هتبقى R2 على R1 A2 على A1، وقلنا ممكن اشيل ال A ويكتب القانون R2 سكوير وهنا R1 ويتحط هنا ايه؟ R1 سكوير. من فوق اقدر اقول ان ايه؟ اقدر اقول ان R2 بيساوي 2R1. من الجبن الاولاني هعمل كروس. ممتاز. طيب يبقى تعالوا نحل كده. كوندكتيفيتي 1 على كوندكتيفيتي 2، احنا عارفين R1 على R2 بتساوي كام؟ 2 to 1. لكن هنا عايز R2 ل R1، يبقى 1 to 2. هقلب الريشيو لان هنا R1 ل R2 وهنا R2 ل R1. هشيل R2 سكوير واحط ايه؟ 4R1 سكوير. وهنا تفضل زي ما هي R1 سكوير. يبقى انا لو هعمل هنا سكوير لازم الناحية دي برضو هعمل ايه؟ سكوير. فبالتالي R2 سكوير هتطلع 4R1 سكوير. هنبتدي نشيل R1 سكوير مع R1 سكوير، هيبقى 1 تايمز 4 اوفر 2 which will be 2 to 1. تمام جدا. اتمنى ان احنا نكون فهمنا الجزء ده. طيب المسائل دي في كتير بيستصعبها، لكن انا شايف هي مسائل سهلة، بس لازم تكون بتعرف تحل معادلات كويس جدا، ولازم تكون منظم في خطواتك. لو انت منظم في خطواتك هتقدر تحل المسائل دي. لو انت مش منظم طبعا لازم هيحصل عندي لخبطة. واهم حاجة ان انا وانا بحل المسألة لازم وانا عمال اقرأ في المسألة اطلع الجيفنز ازاي، لان لو انا غلطت ازاي اكتب الجيفنز في رقم، بدل ما اقول L1 بتساوي 2 L2 عكستها، لا هتديني ناتج تاني ايه خالص. يبقى انا وانا بقرأ المسألة ابتدي اكتب الجيفنز بهدوء جدا. مش المهم ان انا احل كمية مسائل كتيرة بشكل سريع واتلخبط، لكن المهم عندي ان انا المسألة اللي واخدت مني وقت بس نظمتها وتعودت على كده لغاية الامتحان، اعتقد ان ده احسن لنا ايه كلنا. فاعتقد ان الحلقة النهاردة والمحاضرة النهاردة كانت كويسة جدا. اتكلمنا عن الريزيستنس والريزيستيفتي والكوندكتيفتي، عرفنا the main concept related to the dynamic electricity. الحصة الجاية هتبقى مهمة جدا لان احنا هنتكلم عن series and parallel connections، ياريت محدش يفوتها لان دي تعتبر اهم حصة باذن الله في شابتر 1. ازاي اقدر احسب التوتال ريزيستنس في حالة السيريس اند بارلل كونكشن. اقول لكم اعزائي الطلبة والطالبات متشكل ليكم جدا اعزائي الطلبة والطالبات، ونتقابل في الحلقة الجاية من برنامج مدرسة على الهواء. متشكل ليكم جدا اعزائي الطلبة والطالبات.